577 Music Podcast.
All right.
Back again.
It's time to start. Hello to everybody listening or watching right now.
Prince all day.
I got something to get off my chest.
All right, get it off.
I wonder what it is.
Get Do it.
It doesn't matter whether you're listening to the audio for this podcast.
Are you saying the same thing again?
Or even if you're streaming this on our official YouTube channel.
Streaming this.
Streaming.
You know, streaming us.
Who is that?
Streaming us.
Not an extremist. I'm not talking to extremists.
All right.
But if you're streaming this video right now on our official YouTube channel,
that's right.
We're still going to be your host.
Yeah, same thing.
That's
Kevin,
right.
AKA Tur-bo.
That's right.
Jason, AKA YKC, AKA DJ NOB.
Al, AKA Al G.
I thought you said fucker, fucker.
That's what I did say.
That's what I thought you said.
I did say that.
Sorry.
Let me stop. No, I didn't say that.
That's what it sounded like. Sorry. Sorry.
Fucker, fucker. Al G. Don't fuck me. No. Don't say that. Oh, no.
And that means you were listening.
I didn't even introduce myself.
I didn't even introduce myself.
He
didn't even say his intro.
He did. I heard him in spirit. I heard him.
It's yet another smooth intro.
All right. Introduce yourself.
Go ahead.
I'm Eric, a.k.a. the 23rd Stallion.
And that means you are still listening to another edition of the 857 Music Podcast. We discuss music, news.
Confrontational.
Very, very confrontational this morning or evening. News, topics, anything related to music that we feel like talking about, it's going to be said on the 857 Music Podcast.
Right, let's go.
We're not ready yet.
Let's go.
Stream us on iTunes.
You are.
Stitcher.
You are.
Spreaker.
Yeah.
Anywhere that you can hear a podcast.
Yeah, where else?
We're going to be on it.
Where else?
I'm done. I'm finished.
I wanted to see how far you were going to go.
I could have went further than that.
But no, you could.
That sounded like an intro and an outro at the same time.
It did.
Yeah.
We'd be like, where else can you see us? Where?
If you're listening, that's great. You're on one of those. Otherwise, you wouldn't be listening.
True.
Not necessarily true.
No, you could discover other things.
They could stream on video.
Yeah,
we could be downloaded and put on somewhere. Who knows?
That's right, man.
Anywhere. We could be in space right now.
We're on VHS.
That's right.
We're on, let me start. We're on Betamax.
On our old school show. On our old school show, we're going to be on Betamax and VHS.
How ill would that be, man?
I think we're going to.
Really?
Yeah, I think we're going to do that.
Oh shit! I'm excited. That sounds dope.
You gotta use the old camera.
Imagine that. The old school VHS.
The more media, the better. The more media, absolutely.
Yeah, we're gonna do that.
Betamax.
Nice. Yes. Until then.
Alrighty.
Until next time.
Oh shit!
Let's get right into it.
Here it comes.
Let's get right into it.
Snap! We got some news.
We know what that is.
All right. Going on in the neighborhood today, we have.
Oh man, you had it.
Well. We have heard news on Twitter, because that's where all the news comes from, music. What do we have? All right, so we had some shit about Lil Wayne.
And that is your
news. About him. Lil Wayne.
Some shit about him. he tweeted, he said he's pretty much retiring. He's exhausted, and he's retiring.
Wow. Mm.
So who knows if that's true? How many times has this been said?
That shit ain't true.
And it's only been a week.
That shit ain't true,
It's only been a week since he said it.
It's only been a week.
It might be longer.
That's like Jay-Z. That's like Jay-Z retiring.
But, I mean, he's
Wayne
really,
is retiring.
He hasn't done much. He's been on a few songs, a few guest appearances.
I haven't even heard anything.
Carter 5 still has not dropped. People are still waiting. He's still under lawsuits from Cash Money.
He's like, I'm done.
So he's like, yo, this is too much, and I'm on too much.
How old is he? Is he in his 30s yet?
Yeah, he is. He's no longer little.
It's that scissor.
He's no little, he's no longer young money.
Old ass Wayne.
He's old money.
Nah.
Old ass Wayne.
Old money.
But I mean, we'll see where that goes. That's not really news, but it was news in the music business because everybody still wants to know what's going on with him. So.
Wow.
Yeah.
And
I heard from
it's messed up.
No, we'll find out. We'll find out about that.
There's more news?
Oh yeah, there's more news. There's always more.
Excellent. Oh shit.
I don't know, it may be a slow day, but no, we have news from De La Soul. De La Soul.
That's exciting.
Yep. That's it.
Oh shit. All right. Moving on. Let me start off.
All right.
Well, if you didn't know, De La Soul did drop an album at the end of August.
Yeah. Spotify.
It was a Kickstarter.
Mm-hmm.
It was on Kickstarter.
Oh, I remember
and
that.
That's the one that people paid for. So, you know how I paid for the TLC Kickstarter?
Mm-hmm.
I still ain't seen nothing from that.
It
was supposed to be out like last year or something.
Oh, man.
Yeah, we'll see what happens with that. But yeah, this was one I should have supported because it actually came out.
That's great.
And it was the first album in 12 years.
Wow.
12 years.
12 years?
Yeah.
I know it was that long.
Years.
Oh, yeah.
Time flies. And it debuted at number one on the Billboard Rap
what?
Chart.
Good for them.
A day one. Really?
Yeah. Good for them. It's crazy. That's right? Awesome.
What was the last one before this one? Grind 8?
No.
No?
I don't know.
Grind 8, but no, they came out with one right after that.
Uh-huh.
I thought it was two things.
Actually, I don't know if it was a mixtape or it was. I think Grind 8 might have been.
The last album?
I thought it was two albums.
Unless the other one was a mixtape.
Maybe. Mm. I think that's probably what it was. Awesome.
But it debuted at number one.
But that's. That's awesome. Wow.
Crazy.
Yeah.
I want to hear it.
Yeah, I definitely got to check it. It's called And the Anonymous Nobody. So that's what it's called.
And they're from Long Island.
Yeah. All right. And they garnered over 600,000 in donations. So
Making
this an album for the people, funded by the people.
That's dope.
It's more than half a mil.
That's dope.
That's pretty crazy.
So pretty crazy. I don't know who David Bryan is, but he's on the album. Little Dragon. Never heard of these people. Snoop Dogg, 2 Chainz, Usher, and a couple others. So this is the most people they've had on there. Yeah.
Really?
Yeah.
Wow.
Hell yeah.
2 Chainz. Hell yeah.
Pretty cool.
Two Chainz is tolerable.
I guess now. Isn't that terrible? Yeah. He's tolerable now.
But they have a lot of guests on this album. But landed on number 2 in the Billboard's Independent Albums chart and number 12 on the Billboard's Hot 200. Wow. And I haven't heard anything in New York or Long Island. It sucks that we haven't heard one thing about this.
That's crazy.
That's what's wrong.
They don't want you to
That's what's wrong with commercial radio.
That's what's wrong with New York.
Mm. Yeah.
Because if this was like New Orleans and stuff, they'd be like, oh, yeah, we playing this. Nothing but.
Mm-hmm. That's messed up.
But no, we can't support. They can't even support Long Island on Long Island.
Nope.
They want hip hop dead.
Messed up, man.
It really is.
But speaking of groups.
Oh, yeah.
We can get right into the topic at hand. Oh,
smooth segue.
Yeah, I like that. Not bad. Yeah.
Oh, that was sexy. That was sexy.
So this is the podcast that's all about crisscross?
Nah.
Yikes.
Damn.
Yikes. I had to mess it up. It was too smooth. Oh,
anyway.
I had to totally cross this out.
Oh, jeez. Now it's went downhill.
Keep it going.
Jesus. Well, I composed a lot of the reference material from phoenixnewstimes.com.
Okay.
They have a top 10 list of best groups, mm-hmm. and I just took that list, and we're going to talk about it.
We're going to see if
and,
it's worthy.
And yeah, we're just going to read. I'm just going to go down the list.
And
I'm
gonna, if we disagree and have other names, we'll throw it in there.
Yeah, yeah.
Not like but, we don't know about
number 10!
Groups.
But let me go through the list first. I'm going to go through, talk about the group, the members, and the years that they're active, and give a little synopsis about them, and then after that, then you guys can tell me if you have any other.
Could rip them apart.
Well, if you guys
no, actually,
know,
this is a good list.
If you guys didn't know,
this is a really good list.
This podcast is about the best groups,
right?
Mm-hmm. That's what it's about,
right? So
I thought you were talking to me directly. I'm like, I know.
No, pretty much. I agree
best
with
hip-hop
the
groups.
I agree with all the people that are on this list.
Mm-hmm.
Do you agree with the order?
The order. It's not in any particular order.
Okay.
So everybody on here. Yeah,
it is. No, safe way. Because
I mean, to put it in an order that's going to.
That's the best thing about everything being on camera. It looked like Kev smacked the crap out of himself.
I don't know what the fuck.
No, I mean, I thought that was like something crawling on me.
I thought you hate yourself.
No, when you replay that. Dude, when you replay that, it's going to be amazing.
When everybody watches this podcast, they're going to be like, what in the hell?
That's why it's more important to watch the video podcast than the audio.
You see Turbo smack himself for no apparent reason.
And get audio and video.
And you'll know what you know how many fingers I'm holding up right now.
Yeah. If you're watching the same amount that Kev smacked himself with.
I thought I got like 4. I thought it wasn't like 5.
He smacked himself mad hard.
But this list isn't in any particular order. It's just going through the best hip hop groups that have been out. First on the list is Mobb Deep.
I thought that was Mobb Deep.
Mobb Deep.
Mobb Deep.
Mobb Deep.
European. European.
Mobb Deep, they've been active since 1992 and still current.
What?
Yes.
The infamous Mobb Deep.
They're still current, yeah.
They still tour? Excellent.
Yeah.
All right. They're still current. Of the guys was sick, right?
He's been sick. Yeah.
Havoc and Prodigy from Queens, New York. Let's see here.
Every rhyme I write is 25 to life.
So he should be in jail right now.
19 when he wrote that.
Said two of their albums have reached critical success. Mm-hmm. Both in 1995 and 96.
Right. It was on fire. Mm. It was on fire in the 90s.
Okay.
Right. So, I always forget about Mobb Deep.
Any comments on Mobb Deep? Anybody have any?
Surprisingly, no.
No,
I honestly don't. I wasn't big on Mobb Deep, but I did like a song or two by them. Right. So, I mean.
They had some classics.
I wouldn't be like, no, they shouldn't be on the list. I
mean, they had good chemistry.
Good.
They're cool.
So,
I agree.
My take on
50 Cent signed them.
My take is they were Queens. And I wasn't really ever a really big Queens hip hop head. I was more Brooklyn. But
hated. Hate
him. He said, I never hated on them, but I didn't really grasp what they were saying too much. I did have the albums. Don't get me wrong. I had the Infamous and I had Hell on Earth and all that. It might have been the same album. But but I had all the singles and, you know, they were still big in the 90s. So I did have all that stuff. And the beats are crazy. So, I mean, Queens always did have some ill beats, but, you know, I didn't like, who was on that?
that was a gunshot. For,
yeah,
because
man, they,
I'm sorry. I'm sorry.
They're like rep Queens. Come on, man.
I'm excited. I'm excited.
But nah, they, you know, QB was all right. I mean, I didn't, it was like Capone, Noriega, and like a lot of people who I didn't really. I listened to
Lost Boys. Lost Boys.
Yeah. Queens.
I didn't really buy a whole lot of Queens stuff.
Damn.
Number but
I
nine.
I agree with the. I agree with them being on this list. Though.
Yeah, they deserve,
They deserve not opposed to it.
Yeah.
Next one is actually this one's a really good group, Eric B and Rakim.
I keep forgetting like the two people count.
You can't say Eric B without saying Rakim.
Yeah, I always forget like two people.
Well, you can say Rakim.
Whatever.
Yeah, no, it's fucked up though.
You can say Rakim,
but when you say Eric B, it's like you gotta say Rock and Rakim. It's like they go together, man.
All right, no. They, I like the.
It's like Blackalicious, right? Like they're two people as well.
Yeah,
yeah. So it's like
Black and Alicious.
Shout out to Blackalicious.
Here's something I didn't know about Eric B and Rakim. They're from Long Island.
Yeah.
I didn't know that.
I worked with his cousin.
I didn't know that at all.
I didn't know that either. Nobody beats the Wiz.
of course, you know, they have one of my favorite songs from the movie Juice, Know the Ledge.
Oh, yeah.
That's my favorite song. Song amps me up every time, man. Love that fucking song. All I have to do is hear the beginning of it. I'm like, oh, man. I wish I could play it.
I didn't like that song.
Without getting a fucking strike on the goddamn YouTube.
That's fine. You can look it up. We can put the link.
Look it up.
Yes,
look it up,
we'll leave a link in the description for you guys to listen.
I like, what was that? Sometimes I run slow, sometimes I run quick.
Nah, that's nice and smooth.
That's nice
and smooth. Damn, who am I thinking of then?
Jesus.
I don't know, man.
That was nice and smooth.
Was it smooth? They're not the same guy. No, I'm just kidding.
Damn.
No, we're talking Eric B, president, and all that.
Okay, I've been drinking.
It's like, could they really be considered a group? Like, DJ, Jazzy Jeff,
and the Fresh Prince?
Like, would that be a group?
That's definitely
a group. Yeah, that's a group.
Yeah,
this is the 80s.
Yeah, I guess.
Even though it's a DJ and a rapper, they still
they're a team. That's true. They're still a team. Just
still
still
raps.
Would you say Kid and Play is a group?
Yeah. They're both
lyricists.
They both write lyrics.
In the 80s, groups consisted of an MC and a DJ.
Right.
That's just how hip hop was. That's
really by nature.
No, man.
You know?
That's a group.
That's a group.
Anyway, that's 90s. I said 80s.
That's right. All right.
Yeah. Hip hop hooray.
Yeah, they're still a group too, and Vinny was largely a
no.
No. This killed
you. Reference.
You just killed Vinny.
How's that a reference? He wasn't really a lyricist.
No, but he rapped though.
He rapped in every song.
Wow.
But he was more like a hype man.
No, he rapped in every song. He had verses, dude.
He wasn't as good. That's not.
Damn.
That's not that was
just because he wasn't as good,
he
he's not a lyricist.
He called himself a hype man. I'm taking his words. He's like,
damn, man.
Damn. Kept his shit all over Naughty by Nature.
Never thought of Naughty by Nature as Tretch.
Yeah. Yeah.
You listen to that new Tretch song?
Never.
Fucked up.
Moving on down the list.
We just destroyed man shit right
there. Man.
I'm like, Eric B. and Rakim's the same as Nice and Smooth.
Yeah.
I just killed Vinny for no apparent reason.
They're all groups.
Good thing you guys do your research before a podcast.
For real.
That's the truth.
It's better if you don't.
It's more entertaining.
It's pretty funny, man.
No, it's like Vinny didn't write that much, man. He had like
all right, next.
We're not even talking about them.
All right.
He said he had a few bars. Fucked
talk about Eric B. and Rakim.
Okay, so the next group. The next group. And I think nobody here will disagree with me.
I will.
You will?
I will.
You can't disagree with me on this one, man.
All right, let's find out.
A Tribe Called Quest.
See, I'm.
You're like, it hurts.
Since there's no numerical order for that list, I mean, I would just throw them at number one, regardless. I would just put them at number one easily.
No, yeah.
Number one.
It's tough.
Groups.
Hip hop groups all the time.
Number one hip hop group.
Mm-hmm.
We're going to go back to that.
I would. I haven't finished the list, but.
We're going to go back
I
to
would.
That.
Jay, I know you're gonna say Black Eyed Peas, all right? It's not them.
All right? After Fergie or before Fergie? The difference.
No. I actually wanted to talk about that also. After Fergie, before Fergie.
I thought Jay was gonna say the Fat Boys.
Come on.
Oh wait.
Give me some credit.
Here. Yeah. Actually, never mind.
Why would I ever say that?
Oh man.
What number is that? Seven.
So that's actually.
No, that's
the third group that I mentioned. But
I didn't like A Tribe Called Quest.
Here's the thing.
I didn't like A Tribe Called Quest when they first came out. When they were the Dashiki tribe.
Okay.
Like I wasn't all a right. big fan of like when Queen Latifah and everybody came out with that with you know, the wearing the medallions and stuff. I wasn't big on like that. Like,
I'm waiting for the butt for the butt.
Yeah, wasn't me too. Down me too.
Like no, I said first album.
Oh, okay.
I said
okay.
first album.
But and then you go.
And
okay.
then they changed their style and
gotcha.
Got with the times and gotcha. I did like Midnight Marauders and all that. But nice. It was I didn't think of that album as big as everybody thought. I liked Scenario. Scenario wasn't on that album.
Okay.
Does anyone
that was my no, it wasn't on the album.
Anyone want a beer?
Nah, I'm good.
I'll have one.
But I like Scenario. Yeah. Wasn't on there, and that messed that album up for me because I didn't really care about the songs on there. I did like it later on.
Low End Theory and Midnight Marauders were great albums.
Here's something.
Was it Low End? Wait, Midnight Marauders was after Low End Theory.
Low End Theory.
Yes.
So Low End Theory was the one that didn't have it. Then it was on. You know what?
Low End Theory didn't have Scenario.
No, you know what Scenario was on? It was on the Dwick single,
right?
With Gangsta.
Uh-huh.
It was on the B-side of Dwick.
Alright.
I'm making all that noise.
I'm sorry, yeah. It's beer.
Easy with the...
Well, at least they brought back Scenario for the... what was that? The Busta Rhymes, the Dragon, the Abstract album.
That, I mean, it was on. It was re-released on the album.
Yeah.
Yo, check this out, man. The year's active, right?
Mm-hmm.
19...
Well, who's in the group, first of all?
Well, I'm just going to name the years after, and then I'll go through the group.
Nah, because you got to name the group first, and then you go years after.
Alright, fine. I'll go through the group first.
They weren't all...
Of course, everybody knows.
They weren't all active.
A Tribe Called Quest started with... is with Q-Tip, Fife Dawg. The late, great Fife Dawg. Yeah. Ali Shaheed Muhammad.
Ali Shaheed.
DJ producer. And there was a fourth member.
Jarobi.
Jarobi White.
Jarobi White.
Who left after the first album in 1991.
Sounds like a Jedi.
Yep. It does.
Jarobi.
Jarobi, yeah.
Jarobi.
But yeah, he wasn't really.
didn't he also do an album later with Drez of the Black Sheep?
Yeah, that's another group.
Yeah. But this is the weird thing, though. This is years active. It's kind of all over the place. It starts off from 1985 all the way through 1998.
Yeah, that stressed then destroyed them.
Then they stopped from 1998. They came back again in 2006 to 2013.
Mm-hmm.
Then they took a little break, and then they came back in 2015 and present kind of ish. We don't know what's going on. Tribe Called Quest.
Really?
Tribe, yeah.
Yeah.
That was that beef.
Yeah.
When they weren't
so there. Now it's kind of a question mark. It says, when I looked it up, it
says maybe they'll have
present.
Another album, maybe they won't.
So yeah, so it's up in the air. It's a question mark right now. We don't know what
they're
going to do.
Well, they finished eight songs before Fife.
Jarobi should just take
right,
that.
So,
yeah, so hopefully they
when they release it or if they release it is up to the, you know.
Hopefully they do.
Jarobi
I hope so too.
Jarobi
he should just jump back in the group and just.
If he writes it.
Imagine that. Yeah, that would be good.
I'd like to hear him. You know, seriously.
Get in there.
If it was a female group, it would have been over a long time ago.
Yeah.
Yep.
Yeah.
There would have been so much hate.
Yeah.
One album.
Yep.
And someone would have got pregnant.
Make a solo album.
Someone would have got pregnant.
That's
that's
how it always ends.
Didn't end chilly.
That was 702. Yeah. Yeah. Someone got
702,
pregnant.
702, someone got pregnant.
Next.
SWV, someone got old.
Damn.
Damn.
They had an album like 2 years ago. I just saw it.
Really?
Yeah. SWV?
SWV had an album 2 years ago.
I think it was like 2000.
I want to hear that. Seriously.
I'll check it out.
Yeah, it was recent. It was pretty. It was pretty recent.
Yeah.
Coco.
Damn.
With the nails.
Yeah, nails. Nasty. How you wipe your ass?
Damn. All
right, next.
Just took that next somewhere else.
Is I like, De La Soul.
I like how there was like a pause after you said that shit. Was like,
De La.
De La.
Well, Tribe Called Quest definitely deserves it, and so is De La. Absolutely.
Long Island's own De La Soul.
Oh, that's like your favorite rap group, De La Soul. Right?
They are. They
yeah,
are.
Yeah,
they are my favorite rap group.
Really?
Yes. 3 feet high and rising. It's actually this known guy? As a masterpiece.
This guy.
Yeah.
Yeah, well, 3 Feet High and Rising is the only, or they actually pioneered skits on rap. They're like the first people that did it.
Yeah, they work hard in their skits. They put thought in their skits.
Yes. They actually had a comic book that was in the sleeve of the album that went along with the fucking, with the skits.
Oh, that's
so
when you,
that's
when
cool.
You, so when you're listening to it, you're watching the fucking, like one of those, like audio books or whatever.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
Outcast.
So, it was real creative.
He had a comic, for ATLians.
They were the ones that did it first, man. They pioneered that shit. They were like ahead of their time, like doing creative. Like a lot of this shit was out there.
Yeah.
And a lot of like poetry, weird shit, but ahead of their time, man.
Ego trip.
Ahead of the time.
Break of Dawn was 3 feet high and rising, right? Break of Dawn?
Yeah.
They had a lot of singles on it. I did like the singles, most of them. Never really got into the albums of De La Soul.
Me, myself.
I did.
Crazy as it is.
Oh, yeah.
Now we're getting sued. YouTube is taking us off.
And I saw them live in 2013 with, let's see. Drez from Black Sheep, he was on there.
You really want to talk about them?
I'm about to say he keeps coming back.
Drez keeps coming back. I don't know.
He's not on the list.
Drez.
LL Cool J, Ice Cube. It was a really, really great concert. De La Soul is a crazy live
of
show.
Ice Cube.
Yeah,
crazy live show. Live show.
That's what I hear, man.
Yeah,
really I've yet to see them live.
We're not talking about West Side Connection here.
Damn.
Not at all.
I've yet to see them live, but I'd love to see them.
They got the new album, so they're probably going to do some more touring.
Yeah, De La.
They have to perform in Long Island, though.
They've compared A57 to De La Soul, which is weird because I never listened to them. Not like that, no. Damn. I never listened to
them. I didn't listen to them like that either, no. De La. I do like them. I do like them.
I see the similarity.
Me, myself, and I, man.
Skits. We did skits.
Yeah, it's like that. Oh, yeah.
Skits. We did skits. Mass skits.
Number one group, A57.
Me, myself, and I.
All day.
Download it.
It's the master ceremony.
These are comments.
WWE.
These are comments.
But they deserve it. Next group.
What, A57 deserves
it? Damn, man.
Next group. We said enough about De La.
Well, no. We didn't say the names of the people. No.
Oh, sorry.
Yeah, man.
Damn.
Sorry. Maceo. Go ahead. Pasta Noose.
Mm-hmm.
And was it
Dave?
It's just
Dave.
He just said Dave.
Dave.
It's Dave.
That's hilarious.
That's it. It's just Dave.
No, it's like True Boy or something.
No,
it's
Dave.
Dave.
It goes by Dave now.
No, it always has been
Dave.
Yeah.
Maceo, Dave, and Pasta Noose.
Yep.
Amber Boog used to see
how
him
funny
in,
is that?
In
wow.
That's not even like a play on words or anything. No,
that's
it's just
crazy.
Dave.
That's crazy.
But you, what's your rap name? Dave.
Dave.
It's awesome.
My boy used to run into him.
Bug?
My boy used to run into him at Pathmark.
That's
yeah. For real. For real. That's why you stay in Long Island. That's the Long Island.
Yeah.
Yeah.
They had the what is it? I can't even fucking read from here, man.
Principal.
Now what does it say? It's
with his playful wordplay and innovative sampling and witty skits, the band's debut album, 3 Feet High and Rising, has been called a hip-hop masterpiece.
Yes.
There we go.
All right.
Long Island represent.
Yeah.
That's it, man.
And number one on the billboards for an independent album.
Nowadays.
Right.
That's crazy.
Now. That's a good filing.
From 1987 till now.
And they formed that in high school.
No love from commercial radio.
Yeah.
And well, they haven't had an album in 12 years.
Mm-hmm.
That's fucking crazy.
Mm-hmm. That's amazing.
That's crazy.
Was he number one?
Yeah, that's insane.
And Prince Paul put him on? But wasn't Prince Paul part of
De La Soul? That is amazing.
Hell Prince Paul is from Gravediggers.
He discovered him. Yeah.
That's hilarious.
He heard their demo tape and then...
he's the funny guy. Like, he's the funny one from Gravediggers.
Yeah.
Hilarious.
Right. Prince Paul.
Prince Paul.
Yeah.
Is that the one with the voice? Yes. Is that Grim Reaper?
Yes.
Ah, the Grim Reaper.
Yes. That's hilarious.
Oh, man.
Up in the sky. Oh, my. It is I. I miss
drugs.
I miss
drugs. That really album was awesome.
I miss
that album. Was that awesome. Album was awesome. Crazy.
Next.
Oh, you want me to go to the next one?
It definitely was a Wu-Tang album.
That was amazing.
Next on the list is Run-DMC.
Of course.
Years active, 1981 to 2002.
Mm-hmm.
2002.
That's when they stopped, yeah.
No love to Russell Simmons, but I thought Run-DMC was pretty good.
They were still going after Jam Master Jay got killed, right?
I think
it was that. Yeah.
Yeah.
I think they were.
Yeah.
Like 1999 when that happened, right? I think 98, 99.
Rev Run had a reality show with his kids.
I saw his kids at Fridays.
That's damn.
Yep.
How'd they tip?
They didn't tip. They did $5.
Damn.
Yeah.
That was a joke. I thought there were great tippers and stuff like that.
No,
and I was
dead
like,
honest. Dead honest.
Wow.
That wasn't a big deal.
Shame on you.
Well, they didn't know any better, man.
It wasn't a big
deal. There were kids. They didn't know. No one told them.
The kids came in and they tipped $5.
Mm-hmm. It was nothing big.
Damn.
How much was the bill?
I saw Mr. Cheeks at Fridays, too.
Damn. And I'm not surprised for some reason.
I saw Mims, too.
Mims?
You know a guy?
No. Yeah. No. I remember.
This is why I'm here.
I would like it hot.
I saw Flavor Flav at Red Lobster twice. You
of
came
course.
In.
I mean,
we've seen him all around.
Yeah. I've seen him at McDonald's.
In that purple van.
Working.
Remember? He used to be in Roosevelt in the purple van.
Is he the Joker?
This is how you know it's really from Long Island. We lived there.
Yeah, that's true.
This is all up in there.
Damn.
But yeah, from Hollis, Queens, New York. They were founded in 1981. Mm-hmm. That's way before I knew. Wow. I started listening to them like 88, maybe. Mm. I don't remember anything from back then. But they were the first group in the genre to have a gold album. Who the hell is Joe Simmons?
Joe Simmons?
That was his name?
That's, yeah.
Damn.
Yeah.
Daryl McDaniels and Jason Mazzell.
That's
a.k.a. Jam Master J.
Daryl McDaniels, DMC.
Joe Simmons.
Joe Simmons.
That's Run.
That's, that must be Run, yeah.
Joe.
Joe is Run.
His name is Joe.
His name
Daryl,
is Joe.
Daryl McDaniels is DMC.
He's just a plain old Joe.
I thought his name was Rev Run.
I thought it was. Damn. They fooled the shit out of me.
Yeah.
I mean, damn.
And he later became a reverend.
Oh, remember that?
Oh, reading from the book. Reading from the book. That was insane.
That was great. I forgot what song it was.
Remember
it was
when we tried to have Kev do that and he fucked it up? He's like, can't you get through
it
the
pages? It was too complicated.
It was a song with Cam'ron and a bunch of other guys. I think Fat Joe. Like, look it up.
I can't walk and chew bubble.
That was the best scene. He's like,
it was hilarious. He was reading so fast. Next up, we have the Fugees.
Yeah.
La, la, la.
The vocab remix, best song.
It is unfortunate.
Vocab
that
remix.
Album didn't exist.
Come on, man. That song was hilarious.
They were the first group with one album.
That's what I'm saying. I'm like,
that's right.
It
they
sucks
didn't have
that they only had one album. It was
no,
a great
they had
album.
Two albums, Kev.
No, let's be honest. Well, no, that doesn't count. The score is the album that they had. The first one,
you know,
that was like,
I never even thought
like
of that they only had one.
They had one.
They had two albums. But the first album was like, it was out there.
Wait, the first album was
on the PPDPPDP.
That was with the sunglasses song. I wear my sunglasses and
yes,
was
that one.
Yes, okay. That was a gosh awful album.
That was
That was bad.
The score is dope.
Score was not
I love the score.
Score was
that's
not
a,
bad.
That's
that
a classic.
A good
Mona
album.
Lisa, could I get a date on Friday?
That's what it is.
That's
Oh, that was cold.
That's the first one.
Garbage.
Shit.
Prize was still the same prize.
Prize and Wyclef still suck. Like, no, they were pretty shitty.
Prizewell was never acceptable. Never acceptable.
Wyclef
he's
is
rich.
More...
he's rich. Like, he's a like producer.
Ghetto superstar.
Yeah. He's a producer.
Well, they both are, though. They're both behind... They're both...
They got money from that.
Well, Roz had a good voice, but other than that, it was just...
As far as performers, they weren't as good as their producing skills. They have...
Wyclef.
Especially Wyclef.
He's a much better producer
than he is
an
amazing producer.
He's
really, really good at producing.
Rip people
hence
off.
Why he can't do both.
He can steal your money. He can steal your money. Remember they didn't let him in like his hometown, right?
Haiti. So he stole money from him or something.
Something crazy.
That was some charity thing. I don't.
Something crazy. It doesn't surprise me though.
Damn.
But Lauren was
she was so talented.
Amazing on both pretty much
she's
both
so
albums.
Talented.
Even though she was more of a goat on the first album. But she was remarkably amazing on
she's
the
so
second album. And that's the
talented.
Reason why they were famous.
That's true.
Right.
And then she went.
And she sung.
She went kinda
and she sung.
She went kinda crazy.
Well,
like,
look at
like
look
Erykah
at the
Badu
fucking,
crazy.
The years they've been active, man.
Erykah
she went crazy for what you call it, the Marleys.
Oh yeah,
yeah.
yeah.
So look
like,
at that.
Was Ziggy
like
Marley?
Kids?
Ziggy Marley?
Isn't that weird?
I don't know. But the years active. Let's go into
nine
that.
Kids,
so
damn.
Years active. I don't know how many kids. It's probably that though.
Pop them out like.
But years active 1992 through 97, and then 2004 through 2006. So they got together again to do
right.
nothing.
Right.
They did that one song.
What the fuck, though?
They had one song.
What was that one song that was not on their albums?
Recently?
No.
It was a good song.
It was like seven years
We have
ago,
it on our playlist.
For 2 years, though.
We have it on our
the
playlist.
The fuck were they doing for 2 years?
Touring.
Are you talking about Michael Jackson brought you three alive? That one?
I think it was like Take Care or something like that. I don't remember the name.
Hip Hopera, whatever the fuck?
No, but after that.
That's Jay's song. Jay be loving that shit.
Well, they were formerly known as the Translator Crew. And it was Wyclef, Lauryn Hill, and Praz Mitchell? What
the Michael? Translator crew. I didn't know that.
I didn't know that either.
Neither did I.
I think that would have been a cooler name than the Fugees. The Refugees? Yeah, whatever.
The Fugees?
Okay.
You ain't saying nothing.
The Translator crew.
I will have some hot songs from them, but I mean, like Cowboy. I mean, I liked it. Listen to it now. It doesn't really hold up.
Yo,
like, my boy got arrested and he was gone forever. I was like, damn, gun it.
Who was
the
that?
Guy, the dude who was on Cowboy with him?
Yeah, that was...
You know,
the small dude.
He had the dreads.
Yes.
Forte, Matt Forte.
John Forte.
Who's Matt Forte? Yo, Matt Forte is a football player. Fantasy's coming up.
Jeez. John Forte.
It's on the mind.
John Forte was like
John Forte with the dreads.
Member, but something happened. He was like, oh, it was a drug thing. He got arrested for like 10 years.
But you guys don't remember that song, though. He's like, there ain't blood on your shirt, man. That's ketchup.
I don't know how I forgot stuff like that, but we're going to move on.
No, but wait. Ketchup. Before we move on, what if they kept their name in the translator crew and just had subtitles? Let me stop. Let's move on.
Where is it?
But Fugees deserves it. I think they're definitely a musical influence of mine. I like Fugees a lot.
Yeah. Okay, so Beastie Boys. Years active, 1980. Damn. So they were before Run DMC?
Mm-hmm.
Wow. How? That's crazy.
They were before because... Really? Because
I did not know that.
The reason why is because they were a fucking hardcore punk band before.
Okay.
And
they didn't like that life.
Well, the drummer from that band left the group, mm-hmm. and they transitioned into hip hop.
So that was
Run DMC was around.
Wow.
Yeah.
So and they used to tour.
Did they influence Run DMC, or did Run DMC influence them?
That's what I was like. I thought
it was the same band. Rick Rubin, the same producer who created Run
DMC. Mr. Beard.
What year was Run DMC?
81.
81.
Really?
Wow. So they formed a hip hop group. In
they toured
the 80s,
together.
Then they must have. They were pretty much the same thing.
No, they definitely toured together. My older brother, I remember, he went to a Run DMC concert, and Beastie Boys was there.
Yeah.
And the whole tour was both.
That's crazy.
Never a huge fan of them.
It was LL, Run DMC, Beastie Boys, and someone else.
I didn't mind their singles.
And Dougie Fresh.
Dougie Fresh.
Yeah, he opened up the whole thing. Yeah.
How bad is that? That we all just break into a beatbox. Come on. It sounded like freak. It sounded like freak.
It sounded like something.
Jesus Christ. You guys destroyed the microphone.
Sample that.
You guys destroyed the microphone.
Nicki Minaj ruined freak.
Yeah.
That ruined that.
Yeah.
Okay, so yeah. So Beastie Boys consisted of Michael Diamond.
Just read them, which is Mike D, the stage names.
Mike D.
MCA, Adam. Right. Youch.
And Ad-Rock.
And Adam Ad-Rock Horvitz. Originally formed, and you know, it was a band, and the punk band in 1978. So, mm-hmm. Kate Schellenbach. I'm not reading these names.
That's a Schellenbach.
The drummer from the band dropped out in 82. So he was part of them when they started the hip-hop.
Yeah. He was part, but he dropped out.
He's like, nah.
He tried the hip-hop thing, and he was like, nah, this isn't for me.
We did to Al when we started 857.
Yep.
But he had it in the claws that he had to stick around, so there he is.
You guys still haven't taken this chain off my leg, man. Take the shit off. Let me get the key.
I'm not going away.
We can't get rid of Al.
Damn.
We didn't even know we tried. So.
Nope.
Next group on the list
to the floor.
Outkast.
Yeah.
Years active, 1992 to 2006. Aren't they still active?
I would say they're still active.
Not according to Wikipedia.
That's weird.
Not according to Wikipedia.
Unless that shit's wrong.
Love Below. What was it? Not Love Below.
Outkast is one of the greatest.
I love Outkast.
What was it called? What was the last double album?
Speaker Box and Love Below. Right? Yeah.
That was considered their last album? I thought they had
No.
Some soundtrack.
Maybe it was.
I can't think of it. It's like in my head.
It's a soundtrack.
It's in his head.
Hey y'all.
It's like.
This is the group.
Whatever. It was a weird movie. It was a weird movie. So they were formed in 1992. They were very weird. Very weird group.
They were out there with the alien shit.
They came out with TLC on there and their single. It was weird. And if you listen to them on that, look it up.
Now they sound
listen to
very
it. It looked totally
weird.
Different.
Very this weird.
So Andre 3000 and Big Boy incorporated Southern hip hop styles while developing distinctive personas and idiocentric sound that incorporated genres such as funk.
I like Jay reading things. It's awesome.
It's great, right?
Psychedelia and techno and gospel. Techno? What? No techno.
There's some. I can get it. That's what I'm thinking of.
That's techno? Okay.
A little bit.
And gospel.
Influenced.
Gospel. Maybe did you hear that? Because maybe I heard it too. All that shit. Yeah, it's like this.
I can see it being influenced.
All I say is ATLians is one of the best albums of all time.
I agree with that.
Stankonia wasn't bad.
I didn't like that album.
Equimini wasn't bad.
I didn't like that album. I liked songs off that album.
No, AT Aliens was
as an album.
It was the best. As an album, AT Aliens.
The first single from AT Aliens I didn't like.
No.
I did not like that song.
You didn't like Elevators, dude?
No. Did not like that. Still don't like that song to this day.
I like the remix. I can't. The remix on the album.
I don't like that song.
I didn't like the song with, what's that group? They had another group on there with them in one of the songs, and I did not like that song.
Waterfalls?
Something like that.
Was it with the guy who was like, oh, y'all take a biscuit, take a foot. That guy's the worst. That's what he said. That's what he said. It's the worst song. They're not even on it.
I didn't like that.
They're not even on it, and it lasts forever.
I did not like that.
Man, I thought this gig was for me and you. I ain't know that Bill Clampton wants something too.
Yeah, Bill Clampton. Who the hell is Bill Clampton?
But that's Southern. And that was when Southern.
I hated that song as big. So much.
But I didn't really want to count Outkast as Southern because they didn't really sound Southern. Look at I mean, they kind of did. Big Boy sounded. Big Boy sounded.
Big
sound.
Yeah, he did.
But it was just a weird clash that worked somehow.
Artist Storytelling Part 2. Fuck.
No, it was great. Love that song. They did some great stuff in music.
I love that song.
Which leads us to NWA.
Yep.
Yeah, there. I didn't listen to them.
Years active, I didn't listen to them either.
I did.
I listened to them. We've heard the story.
I did.
We've heard the story. Two podcasts.
If you haven't watched the movie.
Dope movie.
Years active.
Dope movie.
Oh,
whoa, what a catch. He caught the
right.
beer.
That's right.
That would have went on my leg.
I caught this shit.
That would have went on my leg.
NWA, they definitely deserve a spot. You know, just for the contribution to hip-hop as a whole. Yeah.
Years absolutely. Active. 1986 to 1991, and then 1998 to 2000.
Wow. A partial reunion.
Partial reunion, because Snoop was part of that.
Right.
Snoop, of course.
And then 2015 through 16, partial reunion, because that one's dead.
Right.
And one's irrelevant. So.
Wow.
So they're from Compton, California, West Coast. West side.
West side.
I didn't want to get on, so I'm easy. Okay, so. Yeah. Arabian Prince. Who?
Who?
Who? Who?
Arabian Prince.
Who?
Go ahead, keep going. Keep going.
Dr. Dre, Eazy-E, Ice Cube, DJ Yella, MC Ren. How many people is this? I thought it was four.
I thought it was four.
It's like six.
I thought
right?
it was four.
It's
six people.
I think it's like six people. Yeah.
They're responsible for popularizing gangster rap in 1986.
Mm-hmm. Mm. Yep.
Causing moms to run scared and hide in their closets.
And side note, the manager, I forgot his name, he died.
Yes, he died. Did. That was supposed to be news this week.
And, I think I read Ice Cube's like, I'm not shedding a tear for that.
Yeah, he's like, I'm not shedding no tears.
They said that the movie caused his death, which was pretty foul.
God, really?
Damn.
Pretty foul.
That's like the ultimate revenge.
Fuck.
He was 91 years old.
Oh, damn.
He was old.
That's a full life.
So they said, but for them to say that the movie caused it. I mean, maybe the stress from the lawsuits he was trying to do.
How about he was old? He's 91 years old.
He lived a full life, man.
Maybe he
lived a full life.
Natural causes.
Maybe they embellished on what he did wrong a little much in the movie, which is.
I never spoke to either of them. I don't know.
I would.
I can't defend him.
It's a movie, so you're not taking everything that serious.
Maybe. Like, you know, Puff and Lil Kim didn't like the way they were portrayed.
Well, yeah, but it's Puff.
I'm Puff sure is never going to like the way
I'm sure he didn't die broke.
MC Hammer didn't like the way he was portrayed in his movie.
and he at least died old. Not everybody get that privilege to die old.
Damn.
Right.
You know? Damn, I didn't say as a 40-year-old. I said in a movie.
Damn.
That's the guy who played him. All right, so final. We're going to talk. Well, there's more groups, but this is the final on the list. Yeah. The Wu-Tang Clan.
I was about to say, dude, who the fuck are you talking about?
The Wu-Tang Clan.
The Wu-Tang Clan.
Quick story. So, I was at a record store called Positive Vibes, right?
Mm-hmm.
In Amityville, Long Island. So their producer or whoever was representing them came into the store when I was there, and he was like, "I got this new record from the Wu-Tang Clan." Hmm. Now, me not knowing or ever hearing about this, was like, who the hell is the Wu-Tang? Like, just listen to how weird that sounds.
Yeah.
Coming to a hip-hop place saying, I got a Wu-Tang Clan.
Yeah.
Now it's like...
Unless you watch Kung Fu movies, then you know.
Yeah, like, I was like, I don't know
Kung Fu movie?
Some rapping guys named Wu-Tang.
Yeah,
right. Like, and, you know, they did have all the karate things. So, yeah. Mm-hmm. And those are VHS tapes and Busy Bee for $4.
Right.
They had the bootlegs.
Yeah, that's right. Yep, Busy Bee.
But I didn't know anything about that. So it was just weird to me. And then I bought it because, you know, what am I else going to do? So I got it. And then I heard Method Man and M-E-T-H-O-D Man and Protect Your Neck were on that.
Mm-hmm.
Those are crazy. It was crazy. I had no idea. So many.
I remember when you first got that. I remember when you first got that.
So years active is 1992 to present.
Yeah.
They're still considered to be together, even though they made a last album.
No. Last time we went to Vegas, well, not this time, but the time before, they were playing at the Link.
Really?
Yeah, they were playing at the Link,
You know, it was cool. Yeah.
They still play.
That's probably why there were so many people in the streets, I noticed, wearing Wu-Tang shirts. Yeah. I'm like, damn, there's a lot
of
people
there
wearing...
That's right, there was a few.
Mm-hmm. A lot of people, though.
Yep.
A lot of people wearing Wu-Tang shirts. I'm like, damn, a lot of people like Wu-Tang out here.
Mm-hmm.
So they're from the dirty slums of Shaolin. No, not really.
The dirty
not really.
slums of Shaolin.
It's right next to Shaolin.
That's how they said it.
It's around the corner.
It's around the corner from Shaolin. Shaolin.
But no, they were from, what you call it? What was it? What was it? It's from
Staten Island.
Staten Island, yes.
Yeah. Well, so, most members
New York,
are from Staten Island.
Yeah. New York City and Staten Island.
Right. Mm.
So it composed of East Coast rappers RZA, GZA, Method Man, Raekwon, Ghostface Killah, Inspector Deck, You Got, Master Killah, Old Dirty Bastard.
And Capitan.
And no. And the Wu-Tang Clan has released...
Yeah, man.
Yes, don't say Capitan. Don't say Capitan. Or Rebel Lioness. Or Rebel Lioness.
No, he's not on that shit.
No, okay, listen. This is who's on the first album. That's Wu-Tang Clan.
Right.
I don't know what happened to Capitan. Maybe he was in jail or something. I still don't call him part of Wu-Tang Clan. But... He had that one long verse.
Wikipedia does.
It was Winter Wars.
Winter Wars. It was
he killed
forever. It was
right.
forever.
He ran over the Method Man tape with the Jeep. Whatever.
Ran over the Method Man tape with the Jeep.
Yes.
Oh, man.
It was so deep. Like, That's the verse. Yo, it's a long, long thing. But Wu-Tang Clan has released 7 gold and platinum studio albums. They're a huge success. That W is like... The marketing genius, like, that's insane.
That's a big.
Seven.
It's a seven. Big group.
Seven gold. Yeah, seven of them.
They only
seven
have,
gold
like,
and
it's
platinum.
It's not
really
a group. It's a clan. It's
they
like
have seven albums. Yeah. And then 7 gold albums and platinum studio.
It's crazy.
And they had solo albums.
Their solo albums are ridiculous. So sales over more than 40 million albums.
That's a lot.
Including that's including the solo members. But they took over the industry since 1992.
Wow.
But they took over the industry by being a group and actually getting deals on the side at other groups. Like,
that's true.
Like Loud was like, where they were signed, but Def Jam signed certain people. Mm-hmm. Like they took over the industry.
It's
they changed
like,
how everything worked.
They were like private contractors. Like they had the main group and
then they could still get back. They could still do shows together
and
make a collective sum.
Yeah.
I don't know how you split that money up to 10 people.
I don't know.
No,
that's
like private.
That's why they have
how
fights.
Do it? They have like disputes and stuff
like that.
But who's getting this money?
You chop it up.
How'd they chop up
10 times?
How did you chop up the coke? RZA's like, no. No. You don't get none of this. And You Got was like, I don't know how I got this. I got the most.
You Got's like, I don't know how I got this. You Got's crazy. I love You Got. He's fucking hilarious.
He's still in Staten Island, man.
I love You Got.
They did live in Cali in a mansion, right? Didn't they have a mansion in Cali? Yeah, they probably had houses everywhere.
So many heads in that.
But You Got is still in the projects.
The amount of money. The amount of money they can.
He's still there.
The amount of money that they can get.
That fucking sucks.
If they go overseas, if they go to Europe or Japan, like they are making.
Oh, forget about it. Yeah, yeah, hell yeah.
Chilling.
They ain't doing a tour, get his ass out the projects. That's fucked
up. He don't
want to
leave the projects.
No, they don't want to leave.
Oh, that's okay. If he doesn't want to leave the projects, okay. I thought he couldn't move out of the projects.
No, he's still there.
Oh, okay.
That's how he got his connects.
Yeah.
In the projects.
Yeah.
But now, listen.
I need an East Coast girl.
So this is the first group that I've had different favorites at different times. So, what was it? Method Man was my first on the album. That was great. That was my favorite. And then it was RZA. And then it was ODB. And then it was You God. It was over time.
That changed.
It just everyone just put out
Raekwon.
Some cool
there's
stuff.
Different flavors.
It was never Raekwon.
I like him.
Damn.
I like Raekwon.
So it was never Raekwon.
Not as number one. No,
I like,
not as number one.
I like Raekwon.
Not
like
as
Raekwon.
Number one. I liked Ice Cream. Like the song, that album, the Pink Tape was dope. Yeah. Pink Tape is still dope.
Inspector Deck. Come on, man.
Inspector Deck was one of mine.
I like Inspector Deck.
I like Inspector Deck for a while.
Master Killer was never.
Come on, man.
He was like a side member like of.
Actually,
of like
Master Killer is probably my least favorite.
I don't even know who that is. I'm not even trying to be an asshole. I don't know who that is.
No, he's my least favorite Wu-Tang.
That's probably
member.
Why I don't know who that is.
He's my least favorite.
Inspector Deck is Rebel INS, right?
I think so.
Yeah.
No, Inspector Deck is not Rebel INS.
Yes, he is.
No,
he is
not.
Yes,
he is. No.
Who's Golden Arms?
Golden Arms.
Oh, that's You Got.
You Got
is Golden Arms.
Everybody had different names. The Chef.
Raekwon.
No, Inspector Deck is Rebel INS.
Definitely not.
They're the same person.
Definitely not. Yes. No way. Yes. No way. Yes.
That's your boy.
No way.
Yes.
Definitely not.
They're still your favorite N-word.
No, no, no. I'm going to look it up right now.
It's a different
persona. Go ahead, look it up.
Oh, wait. Does he rap differently, too?
That's the reason why. It's a different persona.
That's a horrible persona. Dude, this is this like real life? Like, this is like all this time I've never knew that they were the same guy?
Eric's mind is blown right now.
Like, no, no, no.
Ladies and gentlemen.
I'm not even fucking around. Rebel INS is the same as Inspector Deck.
Yes.
The one you did that cool remix with that ill beat.
Yes.
Is the same guys who rapped slow and was high as hell in the studio rapping with Method Man doing those horrible freestyles. That's the same fucking guy.
Same guy.
I thought he was darker and like bald. No?
No.
I'm looking this shit up right now.
Look it up.
And I refuse to believe it.
Who has the most albums from them? Ghostface, right? Yeah. He has the most albums.
Yeah.
Jay, it's funny. When you were
Ghostface
saying.
Ghostface releases like a fucking mixtape every year.
Yeah, and it's ridiculous. It's ridiculous. He's still like.
Literally.
Out
like,
now.
Right. When you first introduced Wu-Tang Clan, you were like, Wu-Tang? And the first thing I thought was like Notorious MSG.
Damn.
Do you remember that
group? I remember that fucking stupid ass group. They're like a comedy like group, though. They're like. The website was funny, though, when you introduced that shit to me.
Yes.
I was like, damn. These
you ever see them?
You say them before Onyx.
They're actually pretty funny.
What's wrong with you?
They're pretty funny, man.
There's a lot of names off this list that should be on there. So no, there I don't is. Know how they don't have Onyx on here as a group.
Onyx is not
on the list.
Onyx is not on the list. They're easily one of the most best rappers.
I popped up in my. I was waiting for Onyx to be.
As a group, they were probably one of my favorite groups because they can't exist.
They deserve it more than Mobb Deep. They deserve more than Mobb Deep.
Actually, I was going to say Nice and Smooth, man.
Nice and Smooth should be there, too.
One of my favorites growing up.
If you're a group that can't exist as a soloist, then you are a group. That's it. You're supposed to be that.
Kid and Play.
Can't be separated.
Black Eyed Peas?
The Roots?
Especially the Roots.
They should be the number one.
Man. What the fuck?
But they're not on there.
You have to make a 20.
That's the thing, though. This is only 10.
They're not bad. These names are not bad whatsoever.
Nobody on this list is like, oh, no, get them off here.
The Dynasty? I'm waiting. Eric doesn't even know what Dynasty is. He'll say it all the time. BD Siegel. He'll say, oh, BD Siegel. And he'll just keep naming them. He don't even know who they are. So this is how much you know.
The Dynasty, not worth mentioning.
Come on, a mill?
Yikes.
And,
they're not worth mentioning.
Another guy.
Yikes.
Yeah, there you go.
Freeway.
There you go.
Yeah, Freeway.
Yikes. Got the hood on Smash.
That song was dope. Nah, but
oh my god, it says on Wikipedia, his name, also known as Rolly Fingers, Fifth Brother, and Rebel INS. Ah, he doesn't know. That's bullshit. That wasn't the same guy that was in the studio.
Yes, it was.
Bullshit. Pull the fucking video.
Stop yelling.
I can't. It's not recording.
Tone it down.
All right.
We're getting back. Okay, we're going to get back to Wu Tang. Then what happened to Wu Tang?
Huh?
ODB died. What happened to Wu Tang after that? He was the heart and soul of Wu-Tang.
That apparently. Took the fire out of them.
Apparently. Yeah.
That album that you played was so bad. And I love Wu-Tang Clan. I love Wu-Tang. That album was terrible.
The W wasn't that great. Black Flag.
Those are way better than the crap he played.
Yeah, no. W was actually...
A Better Tomorrow was horrendous.
I didn't say any of
it. It was like... It was so bad. It was like... Cannabis and Keith Murray bad.
Oh, no.
Now, that's a group that shouldn't be... That's a terrible album.
That's a hard. I like. Oh man, that's one of the worst albums I've ever heard in my life. I was like, why is Keith Murray and Cannabis together?
So this is the thing. Rap groups in the 90s,
right?
You couldn't turn the corner without seeing a group for hip hop.
Yeah,
anywhere. Yeah. Lost Boys, everybody.
Right,
and now. You have maybe one group in hip hop.
Do you have a group?
Yep.
Can you name one?
Slaughterhouse. That's like a clan,
though. I mean, I would call them Ray Shrummer if they came out with more, but Ray Shrummer is probably a group.
Ray Shrummer is a group.
It's two people.
Maybe they rap.
They're like three people.
What's the name of them?
Ray Shrummer.
Rush Shrummer?
That's what I always
call it. It's Drummer. It's
The Drummer's Backwards.
The Drummer, spelled backwards. That's how you read it. Ray Shrummer.
The Drummer.
That's the name of the fucking group, man. They're the only group that's a group. And that's a group.
I don't have anything to say.
They're the only ones.
That's
yelling.
Current, man.
Yeah. Oh, wow.
That's current hip hop.
There was no crisscross.
There was, they're like the closest thing to a new age crisscross.
Yeah, pretty much. They look like that.
They look like them too.
They're young.
Wow.
But yeah, there's no like flavor unit. Like none of these. There's no big group of people.
What about
Flavor unit was like a clique.
Well, yeah, but you put together like
it's Public Enemy a group.
Public Enemy's a group.
That's yeah. a group.
Yeah, that's a
group.
Hype man.
There's a lot. Of, look, there's a Naughty by Nature. You said I was going to say Naughty by Nature. You didn't
think
before.
I was waiting for. They're
a group, but you know what though. Yeah, you gotta have 10. You gotta pick 10 gotta fucking groups, man.
You gotta have two albums. Nah, yeah. Fuji's is on there once. So.
Nah, you could do, if we did a top 20, 20 then it would be on there. Yeah.
Especially yeah. Onyx. I liked a lot of Onyx.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. It was entertaining.
I loved
I never
Onyx.
Took them seriously. Serious. I never took them serious, even though I got robbed twice for the album. Oh. People took them serious.
I got robbed twice for the album.
Give me that fucking album.
They took it. Yeah, I had a bootleg. I had a bootleg
they had a skit on their album about freaking Jack and somebody who's bootlegging their tape. Yeah, and Jay got the fucking tape stolen.
He lived that shit.
No, they recorded them
recorded. They robbed Jay. That was Jay. Recorded on the album.
I got the mixtape.
I had a back the fact up shirt.
Yeah.
It had an A
Onyx
on it.
Tape. Come buy from me.
$3.99.
I remember my somebody friend. In
pop,
the school.
Pop. They had skits. But
skits
were, there was a
were
movie, though.
Hilarious.
Yeah, it was a movie.
It was it Robin Vick? That song with the sticky
oh, Vanessa?
Fingers?
That was,
no.
Oh,
no. That was
the, the brothers?
Yeah. Oh, I love that song.
That was a dope song.
Great storytelling.
Oh, so awesome.
Oh, no. I like Veronica.
Veronica.
Ah, great one, too. Yeah.
That's stupid.
And it's so dumb. I'm like, what?
It was bad dumb.
No, that was a great song, too.
But that's when Sticky went crazy and tried to make that whole album about weird stories. And they were just talking about, like scripts. It was a weird album.
Insane.
So, yeah, he never did it. Absolutely he never insane. Did it from Yes and Solo.
What about Jurassic 5?
Jurassic 5 should be on there.
They're not on there?
Oh, man. Man. But name a song.
There's a lot.
No, that's
true, man. Name
that's
a song.
True. If I had a gun to my head right now, I'd be like, I'm
Blackalicious. Let me stop.
Blackalicious? I love Blackalicious.
They should be on there. Gift the Gab is insane.
I said top 20, man. If you do a top
20 list, also hard. 20's
hard.
Also hard, too.
That's hard. You can't.
Bush Babies are not in this.
What's that other group?
There's so many.
There's a lot.
Your group, Das Effects.
Das Effects is in here.
Best
Camp Low.
Fushnikis.
Camp Low.
Fushnikis ain't in here.
Camp Low.
I still say Das Effects is best duo.
Fushnikis.
We got to do a duo one.
Fushnikis, they don't need to be there. But they're a group.
They are a group.
But how is Meth and Red not? As a group.
They're a group.
And
you know are
they?
Are they
the best?
That, I guess
they are.
Yeah.
They're a group.
It's I see,
a,
it's I see
one
the
of the
more...
best dual groups. Like, yeah. It's one of the best.
I've seen them perform. They were a group.
Yeah.
They're a group.
I guess, yeah. I mean, the CD they, said Method Man.
Well, wait,
so,
wait,
I mean,
wait.
They have
wait,
more albums in the
future. Wait. Wait. To go by what you were saying before, if they can't perform on their own, they're a group.
I know.
That doesn't fit with what you said before.
Q-Tip performed on his own, okay? He's part of Tribe Called Quest.
Yes, but he failed.
Damn!
His album sucks.
He didn't
it was
have
so bad.
He can't. He
I fucking. I tried. I tried to like his fucking album.
He didn't have a solo career.
I tried.
Unless
I tried
you count
so
Kanye.
Hard, man.
Unless you count Kanye's album.
And I like Q-Tip.
Damn, you know it's funny. It's like
I like Q-Tip.
We give so
try.
Much respect, and then we just throw a knife right in.
I tried.
No, we're just going by the statistics.
Man, bought his album, man.
And Wu-Tang is a group, right? You consider
Wu-Tang is a group,
and they sell solo as well.
I guess you gotta consider. I mean, they're like fucking.
But
I consider
high,
them a
no,
clique.
No, no,
that's
listen,
like a clique.
No, they're a group.
This is how it goes. If you are a successful solo artist
who
combined with someone else after the fact, then you're not a group. It's just like tag teams and wrestling.
So Redman and Method Man don't count.
Like Macho Man and Hogan.
Or a rated RKO. Edge and Randy Orton. It doesn't count as a tag team. It's not real.
All right, hold on. So Bad Meets Evil.
Yeah, they don't count as
a group.
No.
They were already successful as solo artists.
That's true.
All
right, I'll go with that.
And Redman, if he was by himself.
Royce the 5'9 was successful.
Damn.
Yes.
Damn.
He wasn't as successful.
Enough,
yes.
I mean, enough to be.
He had like 10 albums. Yes.
That's like the Rockers, you know? They were a tag team, and then Shawn Michaels went off. And just...
But they were still a tag team.
They were still a tag team.
Yeah. This is how we're going by it.
That's how we do it.
Team. After he sweet-chinned them into the... No, I'm just kidding. Mad references.
He went through that glass window.
People
glass
listening, window, you know, like...
Traumatizing. That's what happened to, like, old...
Damn.
You got kicked through the glass, didn't come back.
Real fast. Favorite group all time.
Jesus Christ.
Jesus Christ is not
well,
a group.
That's only one guy. That's
Jesus
only
Christ one guy. Superstar is a group, yes.
Why are you pointing at me for? Why don't I go first?
All right. Favorite group all time.
Favorite group of all time.
All time.
Put on the spot.
Just pick one.
Woo.
That's Effects. Really? Your favorite.
Yeah.
Your favorite all time.
Nope, not that. Next.
All right, Tribe.
It might be Tribe. Yeah, I was like,
I was gonna
it
go
might,
Tribe.
It might
yeah.
be Tribe.
Tribe.
I'm rolling
off the spot.
Rolling Tribe.
Ooh, or Outkast.
Yeah, Outkast is a close.
At least change it up. You can't have all three Tribe.
No.
Man. You put me on the spot, so I can't think of Tribe.
Ow. Tribe or De La?
Tribe.
Come on, yeah. Fat Titties turn to teardrops.
Only reason why is that. I can listen to Three Feet High and Rising.
Might be Outkast.
You didn't say De La? I thought De La would be.
Bobcast.
They're up there, though.
That would be your favorite.
I think Tribe would be above De La. Yeah.
De La top three?
Yeah.
Okay. Any group's album, I'm telling you, if I throw on Dos Effects, I am saying every word, every song. Yeah. I don't care what it is. Except for that third album. Blah, garbage.
They had a third one?
They had a fourth one. Hmm. Yeah. So first two albums, number one duo for me. Mm-hmm. I can say Wu-Tang, but they had a lot of bad.
More than Camp Low.
Yeah.
Oh, Camp Low should have been in there. Oh, man. Camp Low is very weird. Mm-hmm. I love it because of the weirdness. It's like coke rap. I don't do drugs.
He said coke rap.
I don't do drugs, but whatever they do, whatever they do to get those lyrics, it's insane. But I love it. I love it. It's great. It's entertaining.
I don't know what the fuck they're saying, but it's like
it's entertaining. And they murdered the flow.
Yeah,
I wouldn't call it my favorite though.
Okay.
Did everybody go yet?
Yeah. I said.
You said Tribe, right?
Tribe universally. I'm the only.
All right. All right.
Close second, Outkast and Wu-Tang.
No, Dos Effects.
Dos Effects is not on my
to the
top
grave.
Three.
School. And the books in reverse.
All right.
I don't know that guy.
It's terrible. Damn.
We got a pretty in-depth email
here. It's straight.
We got an email from Justin McNeil.
What up?
What up, Justin? McNeil?
He wants to know. He
was
says,
he the same Justin from that movie? Was he the same Justin from that beach movie? From the American Idol?
I'm sorry, Justin McNeil. I don't know
Pick
what
up
the hell.
Justin.
I don't know what he's talking
he's
about.
He's talking about the American Idol frilly haired little.
It's not him?
Kelly Clarkson.
Is that his name?
I don't know.
Justin something?
I don't think it's McNeil.
I just went by Justin.
Damn, we just attacked
anyway,
him for no reason.
Shout out to Justin McNeil for the question. And
yes.
He says,
Timberlake.
Why is it that hip hop and R&B are the only two genres that are lumped together on the radio? I've never heard.
I'm sorry, can you repeat the question, Jake?
Jesus Christ.
I said combine them.
See, I try to ignore Jay when he fucking like tries to interrupt. And it's tough. But here we go. Ready?
Fine.
He says, once again, Justin McNeil says, why is it that hip-hop and R&B are the only two genres that are lumped together on the radio? I've never heard of a rock and jazz or country and soul station. LOL. What are your thoughts?
Okay. Who wants to go first?
Well, they did lump together country and garbage.
No. Well, I'm talking about what I think what he's trying to say is like, why is that the only two genres that are pushed together on a single radio station?
Because of Hot 97. That's why.
Number one, the demographic goes hand in hand. Number two, R&B artists and rap artists do a lot of guest spots on each other.
And the sounds are similar.
They used to.
The sounds, the beats, the melodies are very similar. Also,
you can jack each other's style and put whatever you want.
Very similar.
There are
a lot of singers want to be rappers, and a lot of rappers.
That's I was gonna say that too. It's like nowadays there are rappers who rap and sing at the same time. So it was a little bit of that too.
You never hear a rapper that does country music on the side.
And I think
that's what I'm saying. Like there's no
or
station.
Does rock on the side.
But the thing is that they have R&B stations though
that
just play R&B. But there's no like rap station. It's always rap
that's
and
like,
R&B.
That's like
why is it?
Well, no, if it's R&B, then it's gonna be slow. Like. It'll be soul.
Barry White-ish.
No, they'll have different. They'll have different times that they'll play other stuff too.
Because
but
what it is, I mean, R&B means what?
Rhythm and blues.
Exactly.
Right.
So,
hip-hop's got rhythm.
Okay. So hip-hop.
Hip-hop is the rhythm.
So they have classic hip-hop. They got fucking hardcore. They got gangster rap. They got like there's a whole bunch of genres of rap.
Yeah, but that's a
nowadays.
O'clock.
I'm saying.
I guess no one is though. It's
they
like,
should have a dedicate. I think
that's the 5 o'clock.
They should have.
Ride.
I think
that's
they should.
What you're saying? I was like, I agree.
I couldn't even hear myself because Jay kept interrupting me.
I heard you.
I took it right out of your mind. I was like, yes.
Yeah. If you could get what I was trying to say,
and podcast number eight.
They have.
I'll set this.
They have a dedicated. Yeah, thanks. They have a dedicated R&B station on the radio, on everywhere, no matter where you live. Mm-hmm. But there's no dedicated hip hop station. It's always. Hip hop and R&B
because they think they're tired of it.
They're two genres. Yes, they might be similar, but why can't it just be hip hop? And we're at the like how old is hip hop? Like what?
2 years.
Well, 30, that's a thing too.
30 years old now. Probably,
you said hip hop. There's rap and R&B, but then hip hop isn't R&B a kind of hip hop too?
No.
No, it doesn't. It doesn't.
There's come no hip hop in R&B.
Some people think that R&B is a part of hip hop.
The reason why is because they put them together in the radio station. So if they advertise it like that,
so the
question is why? Why do you think that is? That's the question.
Because a lot of the singers and rappers are black. And they want to put all black people together.
There you go. That's it. That's the answer.
There we go. All black people, one station.
You know what? That might be. That might be it.
That might be. That somebody, might be some exec up front is like, hey, just like.
I honestly don't know.
Put it together.
But this is why.
It's soul music.
What do you
this
think?
This is why. Because of Hot 97. No, that up. They the first ones. They said hip-hop and R&B. And then what came after? Power. We got to compete with Hot 97. Hip-hop and R&B.
Yeah, but that's in New York. What about other hip hop stations and other?
If you go to another state, bite off each
it's
other.
An influence.
They bite off right. each
and
other.
In Philly, they have the same thing, and all the big cities, they do the same thing.
Hot 97 started it.
They started it.
Everyone bites off each other like they and do with everything else.
And now they changed it. It doesn't even say hip hop and R&B anymore. Actually, no. I think it is. I think that's what they call their station now. It's not Hot 97 because they play it. They play it in other places now.
Right. How often do you run into someone who likes R&B but doesn't like rap? Or likes rap and
girls.
Doesn't like R&B.
There are
girls.
People that do. Sometimes. There are people that do like. Yeah, that don't like rap. Or hip hop. And like R&B.
It's the CD 101.9. It's blues all day.
I'm not a big fan of R&B.
I'm really not
a fan of R&B.
I like
but
it.
But when I'm listening to Hot 97 or like a rap station.
But like when you have the lady over, you get that playlist going.
Yeah, you got that Drake.
For myself personally, I'm not a fan of R&B.
Why do you do that?
When you dim the lights, you got the lady over. You gonna play some R. Kelly or something? Some Trey songs? Come on,
you ain't peeing on nobody. I hope not.
Damn, man.
So you ain't peeing on nobody.
No, but.
But when you do your songs, why do you do R&B and rap?
I was trying to set that up. But I don't know if you guys noticed. I was trying to set that up.
It's because of Drake. That's why.
Yes, I was trying to set that up.
See, that's why you got to watch the video podcast. You can see that Alex just like Drake.
Especially now.
No, I don't.
We got a picture.
Actually, we just got back from vacation, and there was a guy. This dude looked exactly like Drake.
Yes.
Looked exactly like Al.
Looked just like Al.
Yeah.
Looked just like
y'all
Al.
Y'all look like brothers.
Damn.
Yep.
For real.
My cousin is out there, man. Yep. Cousin Drake.
Drake squared.
And he was from the Bronx, too,
cousin
right?
Drake.
Yep.
He's the Bronx.
That's hysterical.
Yeah, he's from New York, man.
Of course he is. Drake, mother...
Oh, we didn't talk about Terror Squad. We got throw.
God damn it!
We don't need to talk about Terror.
That's like a click. Shorty, what you want?
But
that wouldn't count
as a group because it came on. They made it afterwards, right? And everybody collectively lost their hearing.
Yeah, like oh shit, I'm gonna have to edit that shit. We're not gonna count that, man. There's way too many groups to mention, man. And you know,
we named them all. That was it.
We only have so much time on this podcast. And
Funk Dubious.
And we're already a damn hour late for these wings.
Yeah, we're mad late. Mad late. So anyway, let's do this outro music real quick.
New one.
All right. That's all we got for you today. So for all those listening or watching,
I like the other one better.
Let us know what you think in the comments.
I'm finished.
I'm sorry.
Just let him finish.
Go ahead.
As I was saying, let us know what you think in the comments. And if you haven't already and you want to see live video recordings of all our podcasts, just go to YouTube and search the official 857 Music channel.
You tell him, Al.
I was trying to take a breath because I said that so fast. I was like, blah, 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 blah.
I set you up perfect.
Now, if you want a shout out, okay, if you want us to say your name,
like a never ending story.
Email all your questions to comments at 857music.com. And for your latest updates, log on to 857music.com.
That's right.
Like us on Facebook, search 857 Hip Hop, and follow us on Twitter at 857 Music. Check out our latest content available on iTunes, Amazon, CD Baby, Stitcher, and most leading digital streaming services.
Woo! Woo! Woo!
And
gotta get through that one.
Finally! What? For more weekly 857 entertainment,
what they
show
do,
your
man?
Support.
What they gotta do for that?
You gotta rate.
Yep.
What else?
That's right. You gotta comment.
What else?
Yeah, what else?
You gotta hit that YouTube subscribe button.
Oh, tell him. Right,
yeah, you know why?
Why?
Because if we hit 1,000 subscribers,
what happens?
Pie in the face.
He takes a pie in the face.
Pie in the face.
He takes a pie in the face if we hit 1,000 subscribers.
Yep. Shit.
But you know what? There's a really important thing.
What?
Peace.
Anything else?
Peace.
That's it? Peace of what? Peace of 5, 7, 7, 7. Music podcast.